Nancy Partridge and David Snyder found themselves in an odd situation when they divorced in late 2007. They were ordered to sell their suburban Denver home as the housing market collapsed around them. To avoid potential bankruptcy, the exes decided to stay together in their home, but sleep in separate quarters.
That was one of those awkward things when you're staggering out first thing in the morning, barely awake, and you run into your ex. It's a little awkward, but you deal with it.
And they weren't alone. As the economy soured, many couples opted to put their divorces on hold. Now, the American Academy of Matrimonial Lawyers finds, after several years of declining divorce cases, the numbers are increasing as the economy improves. In New York, famed divorce attorney Raul Felder says he's also seen an uptick, particularly among clients in the financial industry.
Divorce lawyers' practice is a good barometer of the economy. It's better, but not great. The old moron joke used to be, my husband's broke, he owes everybody's money, we're starving, so forth. Now's the time to sue him for divorce. And that's really why it doesn't happen. You wait till somebody has money, then you sue them for divorce.
The housing market has also changed divorce battles. In Florida, one of the state's hardest hit by plummeting home values, one divorce attorney tells us that instead of fighting to keep a house, duels are now often over who's responsible for the debt.
In a lot of cases, if you do walk away from the home and you don't have any liability, you are considered the winner.
Back in Colorado, Nancy and David consider themselves the winners, but not because of their home value. It's still underwater. But toughing out the recession rekindled their romance.
I think if it weren't for the recession, we wouldn't have gotten back together because we probably would have been living in different states by now.
The couple plans to remarry, and once again they find themselves in another odd situation since many people don't know they're divorced.
How do you explain that? Well, she's not my wife, she's my ex-wife, but she's my fiance, my girlfriend. It's weird. So you just roll with it like we are married for most part.
We joke that the divorce was annulled.
And as Nancy Partridge put it, when life gives you some lemons, you make lemonade out of it. But her story is rare. Divorce attorneys say one trend they are seeing is couples skipping court battles and instead going to mediators in order to cut costs on legal bills.